The investigation into what caused the huge explosions and fires at a Lake County propane plant took a step forward today.
Yeah, federal and local investigators got their first good look at the area where they believe the blast began. WESH 2's Greg Fox is live at the blast scene tonight. And Greg, any early word on the cause?
Well, despite the fact that agents both on the state and federal level have actually had a better opportunity today than yesterday to go over most of the 5.5 to 6 acre property, there is no word on what caused Monday's explosions and fires. But one worker who rescued another is saying human error could be partly to blame. Federal and state experts began the careful and undoubtedly long task of trying to determine a cause for Monday's series of explosions and fires that rocked the Blue Rhino plant, as well as homes and businesses in Lake County.
Obviously, there's a bunch of fuel there, and we're just trying to figure out what was a competent ignition source.
A special agent with the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms said the farthest point in the rear of the 5-acre property appears to be at the center of the initial blast.
Obviously, it all became involved at some point. We're concentrating more on the backside right now, on the far backside.
One worker spoke with the Leesburg Daily Commercial. According to Gene Williams, who saw the forklift operator just after the first explosion, quote, Alan Kelly's legs were burnt bad and his face was burned, and I told him, come on, Alan, I'm going to get you out of here. Williams talked about the potential cause. Quote, a combination of human error and bad practice, possibly. I don't want to speculate any more than that, but that is what the forklift driver was telling me. Investigators confirmed they are looking into the forklift operation.
We did inspect the forklifts that were on the property today. We're not at liberty to speak in detail about what that investigation and what we concluded from those forklifts.
The fire marshal confirmed there is surveillance video, but so far it does not reveal the cause. While water suppression systems operated properly, the fire chief called them outdated and said he's talking with the company about that.
That's part of what we want to talk to the plant about, is we need to look at a way to upgrade that system.
And continuing our own investigation, the parent company, Feral Gas, the parent company of Blue Rhino, we found was cited back in 2008 for more than $24,000 for serious violations after a worker in California at an LP facility was injured, burned, and in part, it was blamed on a lack of safety training. Live in Lake County, Greg Fox, WESH 2 News.